So I think we're here. Nope. Not an idea. So especially early in your career, there's a balance, but you should be trying to write a paper or whatever ideas you don't have an idea. It shouldn't be hard to generate one. Maybe you've read a couple of other papers and just go write a paper and try to make it. I don't recommend you submit one without talking about this with your advisor. This is not ignore your advisor, right? If your advisor says the paper is not good enough to submit, but you don't really have to have a good idea, a good paper. It turns out what you think is a good idea, it may not be good. It might not be, but some of the ideas you think are bad might still make a good paper. Honestly, even if you have a bad idea, write the paper, you may develop a good idea in the first place. To me, writing is when you really develop the idea. You have some inkling of ideas, some intuition that turns into a good idea. And one of the reasons for that has to do with that too. And usually it's going to be much more interesting and challenging than at first it seems. So your idea may not seem great to you, but as you start exploring it, it will evolve. And as the idea evolves, become a good idea. One of the things you want to worry about is why are you writing this paper? What's the purpose of your paper? So why do we write papers? We're writing papers, one sense, we're writing papers for other people, right? So they don't sort of know where they go, right? So right, we write papers and give talks, maybe to impress others, gain recognition, get promoted, right? So that's a fallacy. We do it because the information we want to give others is important. Now, they're going to come in second. So this idea, this is not what I write papers, to turn our simple idea into impenetrable fog and make it so that it seems dense. But I will come back to that. We'll talk today about how to add some mathematical observations to papers. But really, good papers are a fundamental part of research excellence. If you're going to be a good researcher, writing papers, maybe not only, but as I already said, right, as you write the papers, you will get better ideas and you will be better at explaining your ideas. We're not going to have the impact to help us if we can't explain it to them. You have the best idea, but if no one reads the paper because it's so badly written they don't care, then your idea goes nowhere. Right? Your goal is to infect the mind of your reader with your idea. Papers are far more durable than programs. It's not about the software you build in your thesis, you're doing the CS thing, that really matters. Right? Sometimes it will matter. But most of the time, the idea of what you do is way more important than just the raw software. Maybe a dime a dozen, but good papers are a little long. It's not the idea, it's the expression of the idea and how you put it in context and how you put it into a paper that make it fun. So the greatest ideas you have are literally worthless. You have to get those papers out there. And if you take the greatest idea you have and you put it in a paper and publish it in a venue that no one cares about, the idea is wasted. So you do want to worry about where it's going to go and how you're going to get it. You want to get that idea out, which is why you're writing. The idea, right, which I define as a reusable insight, useful to the reader, or hearer, it's a verbal idea, right? But the important thing about the idea is that it is reusable.